just going to go back to the phones now and talk to Kirsten from Brighton. Hello, Kirsten.
Hello, Mike.
Now, your dream for Ian...
Yes?
You're always losing something, aren't you?
Yes. Yes. I've lost my child as the playgroup. I've lost items. And I can't find it. I'm in panic. Or... I'm very much in my previous work situation and I can't find a solution.
Yes, that's a horrible situation to be in. Ian,
yes.
what do you think of Kirsten's predicament?
Okay, Kirsten, when we dream of losing something, there's something in waking life where we're not being recognised, and very often it's our value to other people that's not being recognised. And this is the same that's happening in your other dream about your previous work situation, where there's some problem at work and you're not being recognised there either. And when we're not being recognised, it's usually because we spend all our time looking after other people's needs rather than looking after our own needs. So what these dreams are saying to you is that you should look after yourself a bit more, not in by being selfish, but just setting some boundaries between you and other people who you're always doing things for. So sometimes it's just good to say no to someone when it's something that you don't really want to do.
Right, okay. So, and I also got a question.
Okay.
How do children dream before they can talk?
What they do, Kirsten, is, well, what we all do is we tend to dream in images.
Okay.
So there's evidence that children actually dream while still in the womb. They have that REM activity. So, and the images they have in the womb will just be, they won't be clear, they won't be as sharp. But children dream all the way from before birth, all the way through.
Oh, how interesting.
It is, isn't it? Kirsten, thanks ever so much. Thanks.